When it comes to gaming, it's becoming more and more apparent to me that when you want to find a unique and fun gaming experience, you will probably not find it in AAA games. With the continued disappointment game after game, you end up wondering if you will ever play a game again that doesn't end up being worse than the previous game that you have played. But then, there's indie games. Often seen as uninteresting and a coffee break during Gamescom or E3. But sometimes these indie games are actually hidden gems that you simply have to play. Cult of the Lamb is one of those games. Its concept is pretty simple, just like the game itself. You're a lamb, you have a cult, and you can grow the cult into something that is as strong as possible. That is, if you want. It's not a requirement for you to do so, but the enticement of doing so is definitely there. You can have a cult consisting of 5 members and probably do okay, but you will probably miss out on what is a major part of the game. The start of the cult can be a little bit rough. I find myself spending most of the time just maintaining the cult, and to be quite honest, I get a little bit addicted to it. Before I knew it, I spent another 30 minutes making sure the Twitch chat wasn't going to be mad at me for killing one of them. And yes, you heard that right. Twitch chat. Because with the Twitch integration, you can have your viewers enter a raffle and be part of the cult. They can then also vote on certain things that can happen to you, like dropping bombs or even some stuff that might be even beneficial to you. Which, if I'm honest, is one of the better parts of the game to me, and it really helped making the chat feel like they were part of the game. I'd love to see other games do this and have more Twitch integration, because even though it was pretty broken in Cult of the Lamb from time to time and could definitely do with some fixes, it definitely adds more to the game. It really adds that dynamic between the streamer and the viewers to really make them feel like they're engaged within the game, and honestly, even if it just is a name floating above some characters' heads, it was just a really satisfying. It gave more of a meaning to the cult, and it made sense to do in a game like this, so honestly, be fantastic to see it in other games too. And because of that, I was also motivated to have a large cult, and this also allowed me to then become stronger when I went on my crusades, which is the combat in the game, as well as making the cult self-sustained, so you don't have to spend as much time with a cult making food and preventing the impending doom whenever you go on said crusade. All the effort that I put into the cult ended up paying off too. With a healthy cult, I was able to go on crusades more often and also have stronger weapons while I was doing so. And because my cult was as large as it was, it progressed towards those rewards also came a much quicker. The combat in the game is roguelike, basically meaning that you will go on a crusade and if you die, you have to start at level again without any upgrades. Overall, it can be pretty challenging, but once you figure it out and you got the right upgrades, the game really doesn't become all that much more difficult anymore. There really is a nice balance in between how much time you spend in a cult and how much you can spend in crusades. It just comes down to personal preference. Just keep in mind that the less time you spend in the cult and building up the amount of members you have, the more time you'll probably spend trying to have a more difficult time within the crusades. There's plenty of choice in terms of weapons of abilities that you can choose from, and if you play it smart enough and don't go headfirst into enemies, you'll do just fine. The combat in the game isn't exactly anything revolutionary, but overall feels satisfying, and combined with the wonderful art style, it really is a joy to play. Especially the mini bosses and the boss fights in the game are very well done. And no spoilers, but the end boss in the game is simply great. So for $25, you will have a 10 to 15 hour game that I will highly, and I mean highly, recommend to anyone who's looking for something different and especially something fun to play to pick up. Cult of the Lamb is a breath of fresh air that I really needed after the poor excuse of a Saints Row game that I had to sit through for 15 hours. Just one pro tip. Be careful what you feed your members. Briskets for the biscuit! Please don't die. They're all dropping like flies now. Uh-oh. Yeah, chat, the cult is kind of dying. Uh-oh. This might have been a bad idea. I have 3 left. Oh, he died too. Well, I guess we're left with 2, chat. You know, it could have been worse. It's not looking very good. On that incredibly depressing note, you're all fucking dead.